Let's start by revisiting the illustration we used in the Threads and Concurrency lecture. There, we explained that Threads can be supported at user level, at kernel level, or both. Supporting Threads at the kernel level means that the OS kernel itself is multi-threaded. To do this, the OS kernel maintains some abstraction for a thread, so a data structure to represent threads, and it performs all of the operations like synchronization, scheduling, etc., in order to allow these threads to share the physical resources. Supporting threads at the user level means that there is a user level library that is linked with the application, and this library provides all of the management and the runtime support for threads. It will support a data structure that's needed to implement the thread abstraction and provide all the scheduling, synchronization, and other mechanisms that are needed to make resource management decisions for these threads. In fact, different processes may use entirely different user-level libraries that have different ways to represent threads that support different scheduling mechanisms, etc. We also discussed several mechanisms how user-level threads can be mapped onto the underlying kernel-level threads, and we said these include a one-to-one, many-to-one, and a many-to-many mapping, and briefly touched upon some of the pros and cons of each approach. Now we'll take a more detailed look about what exactly is needed to describe kernel versus user-level threads and to support all of these types of models.